Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. This is me, host Brodswell. Today we'll talk about Foodchain and Truebit Protocol's partnership with Foodchain and the Quadrans Foundation. So let's get started. Before I start, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up as that helps out the channel a lot. If you'd like to be notified of the future uploads, please subscribe and also hit the bell icon. And if you have any suggestions, any queries, or would like to discuss about anything, just leave them in the comments below. All right, so first I'll give a brief overview of Foodchain S.p.A. and the Quadrans Foundation. The Foodchain S.p.A., it was initially started by David Costa and Marco Vitale in 2012. And it was initially started with the goal to protect the Made in Italy brand and tackle the counterfeiting of the products through blockchain technologies. They presented this solution at an expo in Milan in 2015 as the world's first blockchain-powered tool for transparency and traceability of food supply chains. And as a result of a great success and a great feedback, they officially launched Foodchain S.p.A. in 2016. And as time moved on, they expanded this to other sectors as well. And now they serve different sectors such as textile, pharmaceutical, energy, and public administration with projects involving in digital identity and invoicing as well. The team initially did experiments on the Bitcoin's blockchain, which was later moved on to Ethereum once it was launched in 2015. But as you know, Ethereum's lack of scalability and the possible network congestion and the issue that we see now as network fees became a possible threat for the blockchain's future. Thus, Quadrans blockchain was started. It's actually a fork of Ethereum, thus it's a EVM compatible blockchain where EVM stands for Ethereum Virtual Machine. Later, Quadrans Foundation, a non-profit organization, was established under the Swiss law, which actually governs the research, development, and implementation of the Quadrans blockchain. So what are some of the current implementations of the Quadrans blockchain, or what are they currently involved in? So there's a lot of different implementations and uses as well. So I won't be going into detail in each and every one of them, but I'll make sure that all the relatable links to the documents and website will be in the description. So please check them out. The first is Foodchain and the Citrus Productive District of Sicily. It's a project promoted by the Citrus Production District of Sicily, the Arcus High School, with the unconditional contribution of the Coca-Cola Foundation. They've also been awarded a research grant through the Region Lombardia, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly, funding scheme called Fashion Tech. Another exciting project that they're part of is called Woodchain, which is funded by PEFC, which stands for Program for the Endorsement of Forest Certification. And the main goal of Woodchain is to utilize the blockchain technology to forestry or the forest sector, mainly focusing on transparency and complete supervision of wood and timber products and their traceability to their origin, which itself is a huge project. All right, so the main question is, where does Truebit fit in this picture, right? First thing is our Jason Tuch, who is the founder of Truebit, is a member of the crypto board at Quadrans Foundation. As you can see, there's four members in the board. He is just a member, but you can imagine the role he plays as a board member for the whole Quadrans Foundation, which is trying to tackle so many different industry with this supply chain Quadrans blockchain. David and his AMA has also clearly mentioned that they've never seen any technology that even comes closer to what Truebit has to offer or the use case that Truebit has to offer. So now David has mentioned that Truebit can be incorporated in the current food chain architecture to provide interoperability, speed up the process, and scale it for a wider usage. Truebit can also provide the required computation for large-scale industry on the blockchain and help bridge the gap and solve the bottleneck problem that the majority of the blockchains have, right? So you can imagine how big a blockchain will be, or how much of a bigger chunk of a data that the blockchain has to constantly process if it's actually adopted as a part of the food chain supply tracking and information services, right? There is a term called blockchain trilemma, which means a blockchain cannot be completely decentralized, fast, and secure at the same time. So Truebit solves this issue like it is going to solve for Ethereum with ETH 2.0. If you haven't watched that video, I suggest you do so. It will be in the card in the right-hand corner or in the Truebit playlist in the description below as well. For example, If we compare Ethereum with Solana, Avalanche, Ethereum is more decentralized, and thus it's more decentralized. The transactions has to be processed by multiple nodes, and so the gas fees are very high, which is going to be solved by Truebit once ETH 2.0 is launched. If you look in the picture, you can see a clear implementation of Truebit as expected by David or Quadrans Foundation. EO stands for Earth Observation Data. This is provided by NASA. So I'm not a developer, so I cannot tell you exactly in minute detail on what exactly is happening in the picture. But what I found out from what I've read is Truebit will be implemented to carry out tasks that can be used for providing certificates or even to provide traceability on the blockchain, which is a huge chunk of data processing that cannot be done in an efficient, fast, and cost-effective manner on the current blockchain system that we have without something like Truebit. There's nothing else out there that can do what Truebit is doing, right? So now Quadrans blockchain has a coin, and they have a token, and they have a running product and stuff like that, which I will make a video. I'll also go into a bit of a detail on how to mine and how to be a part of this blockchain, as I'm still learning about it. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon if you'd like to be notified as well. But I'd like to go through some of the questions on the recent AMA with David on Reddit, right? There's a couple of interesting questions and really interesting answers that I would like to go through. If you'd like to go through the AMA yourself, there's a link in the description. So just feel free to skip the video and go and read the AMA there if that's what you prefer. The first question was, other than Truebit, did you look at any alternative coins that may have the same utility? To that, David replies, we have not identified any technology that has the same unique capabilities as Truebit. Another user asked, are you planning or considering to use the True token in a possible implementation? So as you know, the devs don't make any money until and unless Truebit is implemented on any blockchain. That's how they've programmed this, right? And also, if Truebit is not implemented in any blockchain, there won't be a steady growth of price for Truebit as well. So implementation and adoption of Truebit is really important. And as you can see, it's David says, yes, we are considering to use the True token for energy sector. More details could be provided during the next few months. Another question is not really related to Truebit, but what it shows is how legit and how serious the team is behind Quadrans Foundation. A user asked about the Italian blockchain community. He's given an answer. The main part that caught my eye is the Ministry of Economic Development has established a task force to address blockchain technology advancement. My colleague and co-founder of Foodchain and president of Quadrans Foundation, Marco Vitale, is one of the 30 appointed experts, right? So the co-founder of the foundation is on a task force that is created by the Ministry of Economic Development. So you can imagine the reach and you can imagine the impact they're going to have as the project sees a wider adoption and eventually Truebit as well. And the last one was, Foodchain and Quadrans are fully private sponsored projects or are supported at institutional level by any government? So to that he answers, Foodchain S.p.A. is a private Italian company, while the Quadrans Foundation is a non-profit organization under Swiss law. The Quadrans Foundation is actually involved in a EU-funded project regarding textile supply chain transparency and traceability, right? So you can imagine, folks, the level of adoption that is going to happen to Truebit once these projects are rolled out, right? So the upcoming few months will be very interesting for Truebit, as we're going to see the merge very soon as well for Ethereum, and hopefully sharding will be implemented somewhere around March or May. And then we'll see how Truebit is actually performing there, or if Truebit is implemented on ETH 2.0, which most probably will. But we got to see, since we don't have any official news. Everything is a speculation at this point. Also, the Quadrans Foundation and the whole supply chain industry is a huge industry that, if Truebit becomes a part of, can attract a lot of other people as well in towards Truebit, which eventually will happen. It's just a matter of time, but it's good news for Truebit and Truebit holders, I suppose. Let me know what your thoughts in the comments below. And like I said, I'm still looking into Quadrans Foundation, the Quadrans coin, how to mine it, how to stake it as well. So that tutorial will be out soon as well. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified once that's up, or feel free to come back to the channel and watch it. Until then, if you made it till the end of the video, please like the video, as that helps out the channel a lot. What are your thoughts on Truebit? What are your expectations on Truebit? Let's have a discussion in the comments, and you have a nice day. Thank you.